والآن أترككم في أيدي أمينة في أيدي رئيس المؤتمر. شكرا لكم جميعا.
Thank you, Ashankiti, for this important assignment that you have just concluded. Your Excellency, the ITU Secretary General, Mr. Holin Zhao, the ITU Directors, Deputy Secretary General, Malcolm Johnson, the ITU Directors, Mr. Francois Ranci, BR, Mr. Chisub Lee, Standards, Mr. Brahima Sano, Development, Your Excellencies, all ministers, ambassadors present here, members of the United Nations bodies, and all invited guests and observers, distinguished delegates, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to first of all start by thanking the Almighty God for making it possible for me to be alive and to be the first African to chair a WRC in the 150 years history of the ITU existence. Let all glory, honor, and adoration be ascribed unto him alone. I would like to use this medium to congratulate our friends from the New Zealand for their victory at the recently concluded 2015 rugby tournament. It is indeed a pleasure to see the spirit with which the Rugby Cup has been won. The spirit of collaboration throughout the tournament is a shining example for us to follow. And I have no doubt this spirit will be flying in this room for all these coming 4 weeks and beyond. I would also like to thank the government of the Federal Republic of Nigeria for accepting to put forward my name for this noble and great assignment. I therefore bring greetings to you from the government and people of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and in particular from Nigeria delegation present at this conference. I would like to express to all of you my sincere appreciation for the confidence you have shown in me by designating me as chairman of this great conference. It is an honor not only for me, but also for my country, Nigeria, and Africa as a whole, to accept this mandate, which is granted for the first time to an African country. I can assure you that I will do my utmost to meet your expectations and fulfill the mandate you have entrusted me with. In selecting me to chair this WRC, you have placed your confidence in me to manage the proceedings efficiently, with complete fairness and impartiality. Be totally assured, I take these responsibilities very seriously. Your Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. The World Radio Communication Conference is one of the most important conferences of the Union. The conference is mandated to examine issues that are at the core of everybody's life in this our present day, as more and more devices and services are requiring the use of radio frequencies to operate and communicate with each other. We will be examining a large number of important and sensitive issues, ranging from mobile broadband communications and broadband satellite systems to emergency communications and disaster relief, including issues related to maritime and aeronautical communications and disaster relief, including monitoring the environment and climate change, universal time and space research, among others. You will all agree with me that as new technological innovations and applications continue to emerge, we discover new ways to make more effective uses of previously allocated spectrum resources, but also new possible uses of spectrum in previously non-allocated blocks and bands. Although this development set new challenges for us, especially in terms of spectrum allocation and harmonization, they most certainly also bring new opportunities for billions more around the world to have access to voice and data services. It is my view that as we collectively focus on these new opportunities at this WRC-15, we should be mindful of the opportunities and benefits of all. This conference will also be dealing with issues covering a wide frequency range and concerning a wide variety of radio communication services that the public relies on for such essentials as health, information, education, security, and safety. The agenda we have before us is a daunting challenge. The sheer size of the agenda, which is over 80, makes it imperative that we work with unprecedented efficiency. It will test all of our skills in being able to consider approximately the several individual proposals from member states and regional groupings within less than 4 weeks to reach conclusions and decide on final acts to reflect those conclusions. Your Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, I am confident and optimistic that we will be able to consider all these matters during this conference, thanks to the good work carried out during the past 4 years by ITUR's various study groups and working parties. I would like to recognize the contribution of study group and working parties chairmen, as well as those who have participated and contributed to their work. My gratitude also goes to the staff of the Radio Communication Bureau, and in particular to its director, Mr. Francois Rancy, who shared his significant expertise and provided the necessary support to ensure the success of this preparatory work. I congratulate my brother, who is an elder brother and friend, Mr. Abubakar Zumba, who has had the difficult task of chairing the conference preparatory meeting and was able to prepare a foundation document which provided the various methods for addressing the WRC-15 agenda items. This particular document, I believe, have already helped us to prepare ourselves for this great conference. I hope that during the coming 4 weeks, we will be working together, benefiting from the experience and knowledge of numerous experts from the participating member state administrations, aiming at adopting resolutions that, while serving the interests of the member states, will contribute to the strengthening of the ITU and its role in helping connecting the world and enhancing the global use of radio communication services. The decisions we take here on the radio regulations are critical to our administrations, to much of the telecommunications industry, and for the many other important uses of the radio frequency spectrum. They will further promote connectivity, directly affect the lives of our citizens, and have important economic impacts in each of our countries. I am aware that a lot of preparatory meetings have been held at national, sub-regional, and regional levels, which ended up with an inter-regional workshop. These preparatory meetings provided the needed platform for cross-fertilization and sharing of ideas and experiences and facilitated our preparation for this great event. However, I am pleased to note that consensus on a significant number of issues has already been developed as a result of those preparatory processes. I will like to use this opportunity to urge all delegations not to allow the gains of these preparatory works to go down the drain, but to use that as a stepping stone towards achieving and arriving at greater consensus and compromises that will be beneficial to all. I expect the result of this conference to be an all-win-win affair. I also want to urge all services to consider each other as complementary and not as rivals. Let each service put itself in the other service position and assume it were in the service shoe. Doing that will create a better and conducive atmosphere for consultations, negotiation, and arriving at much better consensus and compromises without anyone feeling bad or cheated. I am counting on your support and cooperation to achieve the goals and objectives of this conference. I'm open to suggestions from any of you at any time during the conference, as this is also going to be a great learning process for me. Doing all this will go a long way to help advance our deliberations and achieve consensus and compromises that ITU is always known for. In order to make the progress required, delegations will have to work in a spirit of cooperation and compromise. I will prefer that, to the extent possible, we work by consensus, and in my capacity as chairman, I will encourage each committee chairman to resolve all issues within their respective committees. I would like to renew my gratitude to all of you for the confidence you have placed on me. I wish to reiterate that I count on your cooperation and continue maximum support in this opportunity to ensure that the conference takes place in a climate of mutual respect, understanding, and constructive exchange of ideas as we advance in this discussion on the important issues that we have before us. Together, I believe we will take effective decisions in the tradition of the ITU. I have to once again thank all the African administrations and ATU for collectively putting my name forward for this noble assignment. And I thank my country, Nigeria, for giving me this unique opportunity to serve the global community. I must, before closing, place my special thanks to one particular individual who have been a professional colleague for several years now. He has nurtured me professionally and given me very useful advice from time to time. He encouraged me to be a leader, and I am very proud of him. He is not any other person than Engineer Shola Tello, who is now the new Secretary General of the Commonwealth Telecommunication Organization. I salute you, Mr. Tello. Merci beaucoup, gracias, shukran, pasiba, sheshe, and thank you all for listening.